I've watched enough Scooby-Doo to know that life's better when life's spooky. So, without further ado, here are five of the most haunted places I've been in New Zealand, in no particular order. The Rotorua Museum. There's a lot about this place that would lead you to believe it's haunted. The spooky basement, the spooky attic, the part in the tour where they tell you it's haunted. At one point, you'd be walking through the basement and you'd see this creepy guy at the corner of your eye. I know it doesn't sound that creepy, but trust me, it is. Between 1886 and 1901, there were a couple of mummified cats that were found in the remains of the Tarawera eruption, and one of those cats was kept in the museum collection. I wanted to talk about how maybe the ghost of the mummified cat roamed the halls of the museum late at night, but it turns out when the cat was part of the museum collection, the museum was held in the old Civic Center. And when they moved everything over to the current museum, the cat had been in storage and was nowhere to be found. They do still have a prop mummified cat in their collection, but I think it would be a bit of a stretch to say that the ghost of a prop mummified cat is haunting the museum. Anyway, next on the list, the old mall by the film school I went to. This one doesn't really have a story, it's just a gloomy old mall with flickering lights, but I like to say that it's haunted. The graveyard by my friend's house. One of my friends lives near a graveyard, and one day while walking her dog Cooper, we decided to cut through the graveyard. Part of the way through, Cooper freaked out and started barking and trying to get away as fast as possible. My friend says that Cooper does that anytime they're in that part of the graveyard, and if movies have taught me anything, her dog is sensing a ghost or something, which means that place is haunted. Next up we have my bedroom in the flat I used to live in. We used to call this room the dungeon, because not only was it the lowermost room, it was also the coldest and darkest. I remember waking up one Saturday morning and seeing a spooky handprint on the window. Could this handprint have been left by a living person one day, and I just happened to notice it then? No. It was definitely a ghost. And, would you believe when I got home that night, the whole flat had been burned down. Okay, that part's made up, but the spooky handprint was real. And finally, Antonio Hall. Antonio Hall was an old earthquake-damaged building in Christchurch that had 279 rooms, including over 100 bedrooms. Since it was run down, people like to say that it was haunted. And, since it was a creepy old house, a lot of student horror films were shot there. I got the opportunity to go there when one of the students at my film school was looking for people to come along and aid in their film shoot. My friends kindly said they would help, and I wanted to see the inside of the building, so I tagged along for a bit. I actually wanted to see if it would be a good location for my student film, and I came to the conclusion that it would be. The place burned down before I got the chance to film there. For real this time.
Yes, we're just meters away from Antonio Hall, which behind me is well and truly ablaze at this point.
I want to end this video with a disclaimer that I didn't put at the start, because if I did, it would make you less inclined to watch the whole video. I don't believe in ghosts.